نستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره، ونعوذ بالله العظيم من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت، بيده الخير وهو على كل شيء قدير. وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله، بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح للأمة وكشف الغمة وجاهد في سبيل الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين. فاجزه اللهم عنا خير ما جازيت رسولًا عن أمته ونبيًا عن قومه، وارض اللهم عن أصحابه وأزواجه وذريته والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. ثم أما بعد، my dear brothers and sisters, the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Al-Qur'an al-Kareem. The Qur'an is made up of 114 surah, 114 chapters. And the 113 is Surah Al-Falaq, the one before last. This surah, like the neighbors of it, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٌ before it, and قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ after it, is perhaps the most recited after Al-Fatiha. And today I would like to share with you the power of Surah Al-Falaq. Many read it, don't understand the words, the meanings, the depth, the importance, what is actually being said by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as we all know, the traditions of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the background of the surah, Aisha radiallahu anha reported in Sahih Bukhari and Muslim that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he used to go to bed, he used to recite and put his hands like this, Surah قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٌ قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ, and would blow three times and then wipe over his front body as much as he could. And when he became sick, Aisha radiallahu anha started to do the same thing for him. So there has to be a huge significance to this, an amazing significance to this. Because when we recite أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل أعوذ برب الفلق من شر ما خلق ومن شر غاسق إذا وقب ومن شر النفاثات في العقد ومن شر حاسد إذا حسد. Let me lay it out for you. The beginning is قُلْ, say, أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ. أَعُوذُ in the Arabic language is I seek refuge, because many in the masajid who give dars and khutbah, they give examples. It is not really the translation, the tafsir, the real background of every letter, every word, and the position of that word in that ayah, and what the Arabs said about it, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decided that his message is in Arabic, is the Arabic language. And by the way, the Arabic language now is exceeding any other language in existence, will remain so and will grow to become the number one language on this planet. Many, many governments, as we speak, their unclassified documentations is kept in Arabic because it's the only language that is protected and will remain protected. They recognize that fact. And look at us now, 1400 and more and beyond, we repeat the same exact language and grammar. قُلْ أَعُوذُ أَعُوذُ I seek refuge to who? بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ. Allah used here رَبْ. A And by default, Rabb is the meaning is the creator, the sustainer, who gives you rizq, who gives you shifa, who created everything is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ar-Rabb. قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ. You are seeking refuge to the creator. What more? If your protector is Allah, do you fear anything after that? Are you short of anything? Are you in fear of anything? Are you insecure? Do you really have a peace of mind? Of course. رَبِّ الْفَلَقِ. And the word al-falaq, many in the tafsir, it says the morning, as-subh, the morning. But the falaq, the word itself, it means anything that's cracked and something comes out of it. So the night ends, the darkness ends, and what comes out of it is the light, is the guidance, the seeds of the plants. They crack in the ground to open up and give life, and another plant, a green plantation, by seeds that we think there's no life in them, there's no hope. And we plant the seeds, and all of a sudden the plants and the green and life comes out of it. فَالِقُ الْإِصْبَاحِ فَالِقُ الْحَبِّ وَالنَّوَى سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى. It is the creation. So you are seeking refuge to the creator of everything. The most powerful support you can ever get is from the creator of the universe and everything in it. As a matter of fact, all science leads to the theory that the beginning of universe was this huge explosion. That out of it came the stars and the planets. Life came after that. And now there are spaceships detecting in the universe, in the galaxies, is there another life? And they are tracking planets that have suns similar to ours. The same recipe of this creation, there might be life. We might be an extension for another life. And back to Al-Falaq, when you recite, قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ. الْفَلَقِ means it's this crack, this opening. So people fear nights. The night, the darkness. We know there is so much unknown in this darkness, in this night. And the day comes rushing through. The sun rises to guide and gives a peace. Look at each and every one of us. The difference in feeling when you have an overcast morning versus a sunny morning. The nafs, the insan, changes perspective because of that light after a long night of darkness. قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ مِنْ شَرِّ مَا خَلَقِ. The first thing you seek refuge from is from every evil that's been created. And I enjoyed listening and watching on YouTube and other cable television stations and reading in the tafsir this sharri ma khalaq. It is so fascinating, wallahi. Like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is perfect. The creation is not. Let me share with you a very popular example. Is death evil? Because we are imperfect, we have to die. We have to finish. We have to end. We have a beginning and we have an end. And again, al-falaq, when a child, when a baby is born, coming out of darkness into this life, is this journey, is death evil? It's going to happen. It's imminent. Because we are imperfect. So, you are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect you from the evil of this unwanted, undesired end, which is death. So we can proceed to the second life, the second part of our journey, with peace. With peace. اللهم إنك أنت السلام ومنك السلام تباركت يا ذا الجلال والإكرام. And the happiness is the happy ending. How do we depart from this life? Although it is bad, sickness is an evil thing. Nobody wants to be sick. But yet, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us from that and to remain healthy so we can go about running our business and our lives as parents, as families, as grandparents, as siblings, as grandchildren, as students and teachers, employees and employers and bosses, and so forth and so on. مِن شَرِّ مَا خَلَقْ. Just have that power in your heart. Be conscious. أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقْ مِن شَرِّ مَا خَلَقْ. From everything evil that's been created out there. Because we don't know. The unknown is so scary. The destiny is way far into the future, into the horizons. We cannot project, we cannot detect, we cannot define, we cannot have outlines and boundaries of it, so we know. Because the human being is always anxious. It's just like a student going to the class and there is an exam. The feeling when the teacher says all of a sudden there is a quiz, and the students, at least most of them, did not study. We're not prepared. Anxiety. And also, when you hear you are an engineer and all of a sudden the company is laying off employees, they are restructuring, the anxiety coming back to home, going back to work, you don't know if you will be going to be handed a pink slip that no longer you will be having a job and having income to pay your bills and bring food to the table. Anxiety. The unknown, مِن شَرِّ مَا خَلَقْ. Anything that's bad, anything that's evil. قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقْ مِن شَرِّ مَا خَلَقْ وَمِن شَرِّ غَاسِقٍ إِذَا وَقَبْ. Now three things are the most severe on a human being. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala started مِن شَرِّ مَا خَلَقْ. If it's so general, then we go into details now. Three things to be remembered. وَمِن شَرِّ غَاسِقٍ إِذَا وَقَبْ. Ghasiq in the Arabic language is the night time. When night time comes, darkness, just imagine you were driving and all of a sudden the clouds, thick clouds come over you. How do you feel? It is not easy when the darkness and the shadow comes over and penetrates in the environment. You no longer see the lights come on. Everybody has to turn their lights, the cars, the homes, the streets, and so forth and so on. And if you all of a sudden driving on a side road and there are no lights, the feeling immediately changes. So Allah, you are seeking refuge to protect you from going into this situation that you immediately don't know what to do. So many unknowns. It is scary. It's fearful. That's why it is the sunnah to get all the kids home, inside the home, not playing outside, just before sunset, before darkness. The shaitans are spreading now, the thoughts, and that's why they call it nightclubs. That's why the nightlife, the shaitan, especially those, my message to those bachelors who are living by themselves, and the students who are somewhere, the nightlife is deadly, it's lethal if you don't pay attention to your iman and your deen. مِن شَرِّ غَاسِقٍ إِذَا وَقَبْ. Waqab means, it's like in Arabic, it is a hole in a mountain where it is out of there, the water gushes out. Because if you go in at night, there might be a dangerous animal. There might be a thief or a robber. Or a gang, or somebody, something unknown. You need to seek refuge from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from that. وَمِن شَرِّ النَّفَّاثَاتِ فِي الْعُقَدِ. النَّفَّاثَات means the ones that blow, the nafs, the evil nafs that complicate things. If there is a dispute between two spouses and divorce is about to happen, good people try to unite, reconcile, mediate, present good ideas, try to make up things, unite that family, keep it intact, and the evil nafs and nufus will always bring about, I don't think it's going to happen. They will not make it. It's a shaitan evil nafs. النفاثات في العقد. عقد, it's a tie. And before we explain about the word aqidah, aqidah, it's a knot. You tie it, and you hold on to it with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And those people, we have an issue. Yet they come to all, you know, add fuel to the fire. Life is in the hands of Allah azza wa jal. What's meant for us will never be touched by anybody. And that's why we need to seek refuge. We need to come back to understand when we read قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ. We do in the sunnah and we're looking around. Are we paying attention that I am seeking refuge from the creator of this universe that is so fascinating, so powerful, and it could be dangerous to me and my iman and my deen and my family and my rizq? If I don't pay attention to halal and haram, right and wrong, to the best of my ability, we need all the time to be reminded. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make this occasion and this blessed day of our Jum'ah a big reminder, a wake-up call for us to come back and seek refuge from Allah. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله حمد الشاكرين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ولي الصالحين المصلحين المخلصين المخلصين. أسأل الله عز وجل أن يجعلني وإياكم منهم وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله عليه أفضل الصلاة وأزكى التسليم بأبي وأمي يا رسول الله. Brothers and sisters, the brothers who came late today, the minute the Imam sits on the member, your Jum'ah is over. The books are over. You're not recorded. You will not be liable that you did not attend. You attended. But did you get ajr? The answer is no. The issue is not with me as a person. The issue is with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Sharia says that. Just like we recite, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدْ قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ. My message to you, you have made an investment today and came here, but you did not get any profits, except not being liable. We have to take Jum'ah very seriously. We have to show up on time. Because there is nothing on this planet more important than this. And the warning came in Surah Al-Jum'ah. There is a surah. An entire surah talks about Al-Jum'ah. يا أيها الذين آمنوا إذا نودي للصلاة من يوم الجمعة فاسعوا إلى ذكر الله وذروا البيع. Business is over. Your phone calls, your texts, your emails, your everything is over. This is Allah is telling us. And I would deceive you, and first I would deceive myself if I do not remind once in a while. Because what's in the point? We set up a Jum'ah. We prepare for it. We live it. And the brothers are coming late. What's the point? We have to take our deen seriously. This is a reflection of the ummah. This is a reflection of the community. It's a reflection of each and every one of us. What is your priority on a day of Jum'ah? If you have a calendar, you should be not only conscious, you should be scared. Am I going to miss Jum'ah, this Jum'ah? Meaning, I have to be on time, not just show up in the parking and come here. I would lie to you. I would deceive you. I would be your enemy if I keep silent. Because I love you, and I'm scared myself not to say it and do it my own self. Brothers, this Jum'ah is so precious in the eyes of Allah Azza wa Jalla. There are times, locations like Mecca, Medina, and Al-Quds al-Sharif, Bayt al-Maqdis, Al-Aqsa. There are times and conditions like when you are in sujood, you are closest to Allah Azza wa Jalla. And there are times like Al-Jum'ah, Ramadan, Laylatul Qadr, Al-Hajj, that we cannot afford to miss, and miss well, and take it lightly. We cannot do that. We are teaching our own children that when they get too busy in business, Ya Akhi, I am a top IT consultant, so what? Are you more important than Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam? You have to answer to this, and I have to answer to it. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us and guide us so we can get back with Allah and recite قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ full-hearted, conscious, awake, living every one of it. And remember the three things. Remember the three things. You seek refuge for the unknown and from those who cause harm and evil nafs. And third, from the hasad. So you may be protected by who? By Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty. Allahumma ighfir lana dhunubana, wastur lana uyubana. Allahumma alif bayna qulubina, wajma' ala al-haqq juhudana. Allahumma tawaffana wa anta radin anna. Rabbana alayka tawakkalna wa ilayka anabna wa ilayka al-masir. يا حي يا قيوم برحمتك نستغيث أصلح لنا شأننا كله ولا تكلنا إلى أنفسنا طرفة عين اللهم احفظ شباب المسلمين اللهم اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين اللهم ارحم موتانا وموتى المسلمين اللهم ارزقنا الرزق الحلال وبارك لنا فيه وباعد بيننا وبين الحرام كما باعدت بين المشرق والمغرب اللهم كن للأمة الإسلامية اللهم انصر المؤمنين المجاهدين في سبيلك في فلسطين وفي مصر وفي تونس وفي ليبيا وفي السودان وفي الجزائر وفي موريتانيا وفي اليمن وفي العراق وفي لبنان وفي كل مكان يا رب العالمين اللهم كن للمؤمنين والمؤمنات اللهم كن للأرامل والأيتام والمساكين والمحتاجين يا رب العالمين إنك يا مولانا أنت الكريم أنت الأعز الأكرم يا ربنا يا ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا فإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون فاذكروا الله العظيم يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون وأقم الصلاة